the launch of Apollo 8, right here where it actually happened. Mankind is about to leave his planet behind and journey to another. It is one of those rare moments when history is not being made, destiny is being embraced.
This is launch control. T-minus 3 minutes and coming. We've completed our communications checks with the Apollo 8 astronauts in the cabin, and the communications are go. During this period, once we do get the firing in, the various tanks within the three stages of Saturn V launch vehicle begin to pressurize. We have firing command. The firing command is in. We are now on the automatic sequence. 2 minutes, 2 minutes, 20 seconds. Our status board indicates that all aspects are ready. Instrument unit is ready. Spacecraft ready. Final check of the emergency detection system. That may be light also now. First stage preparations are completed.
All systems remain okay.
Okay, keep going. Ready to go to Conway.
Command by water.
Okay, you're on.
All systems go.
T-minus 45 seconds and coming. First stage, the oxygen tank has been pressurized and the pressure is still building up. Seconds, 1, 2 minutes, 90 seconds in coming. The Apollo 8 crew standing by, Spacecraft Commander Frank Borman, General Air, Bill Anders. We now report that the liquid hydrogen tank in the third stage is pressurized. 1 minute, 15 seconds. All third stage propellants pressurized at this time as we come up on the 60-second mark on the flex of the room. 60 seconds in coming, the vehicle now is completely pressurized. We're coming up on a power transfer shortly. We have the power transfer, we're now on the flight batteries within the launch vehicle. Final reports from Borman at this time. Final look at the switches aboard the spacecraft. 20 seconds, all aspects, we are still in the go at this time. 2 minutes, 15, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10.
returned safely to the Earth. I know. I'm Jim Lovell, and I was one of the crew of this spacecraft, Apollo 8. We were the first men to see the surface of the moon from just a few miles away. But it was the hundreds of thousands of men and women who worked on that team, and the millions of people who supported the mission that really made it possible. That way, I guess, we all went to the moon. Now, on the other side of those doors, you'll find an actual Saturn V moon rocket. It's still the most powerful, the most complex machine ever built. And I guess it's the only one that can take you to another planet. I actually got to fly one on a second flight to the moon called Apollo 13. But that's another story.